Sunrise, Florida, the Florida Panthers surrendered 3 unanswered goals in the third period to fall to the St. Louis Blues 3-2 at BB. It's 2-0 and you've got to find a way to shut them down and get the 2 points, for sure. The Panthers took a 1-0 lead on a power play goal from Henrik Borgstrom at 18:55 of the first period. After holding the lead for the first 40 minutes, the Panthers built on their advantage with another power play goal just 30 seconds into the final frame from captain Alexander Barkov. But after that goal, the Blues went on the offensive, as defenseman Colton Pareko scored on a wraparound at 3:05 to cut Florida's lead in half at 2-1. From there, St. Louis continued to make a strong push, with Ryan O'Reilly jumping on a loose puck in the slot to tie the game 2-2 at 11:09. At 16:17, Vince Dunn scored the game winner on a wrist shot from the high slot to make it 3-2. "We were playing in our end too much," Boughner said. "We got the puck, we'd go down, we'd turn it over. We started getting a little too fancy. Then you spend the next 30 to 40 seconds in your end. It was shift after shift they started building momentum. Even when we made it 2-0, 2 power play goals, we didn't step on their throat." Here are 5 takeaways from Tuesday's loss in Sunrise. Point 1. Brush strokes. The artist used his brush like a broom on Tuesday night, setting up shop right on top of the crease on the power play. Borgstrom swept a deflected puck past goaltender Jordan Binnington and into the net to give the Panthers a 1-0 lead with 1:05 left in the first period. Aaron Ekblit and Frank Vetrano were credited with assists on the play. Video, STL8 Florida. Borgstrom sweeps home puck for PPG. "Of course it feels good to score," said Borgstrom, the 23rd overall pick in the 2016 NHL draft. "I thought we deserved the goal in the first period, but, well, it doesn't really feel like anything." In the midst of his rookie season with Florida, Borgstrom has carved out a nice role for himself as the team's third-line center since the return of Vincent Trocheck. In 21 games, the 21-year-old has registered 5 goals and 3 assists while averaging 14.13 of ice time per game. Point 2. The Rick notes Borgstrom's goal was the cherry on top of a great opening period for the Panthers. Holding St. Louis without a shot on goal for almost 10 full minutes after the puck had dropped, Florida finished the first 20 minutes with an 11-5 advantage in that category. In terms of puck possession, they also bested the Blues in shot attempts, 20-9, and scoring chances, 7-6. James Reimer made 2 high-danger saves in the first, including a massive kick save on Mackenzie McEachern to keep the game scoreless just past the midway point of the period. Video, STL8 Florida. Reimer shuts down McEachern's tip and try in the first period. "We had our chances," Barkov said. "We should have just kept playing the way we played in the first period." The Panthers have now allowed just 2 first-period goals over their last 6 games. Point 3. Living on the edge, Barkov found the back of the net for the second time in as many games on Tuesday night. With the Panthers on the power play to start the third period, Mike Hoffman skated behind the net before finding Barkov dug in on the edge of the crease, where the 23-year-old center stuffed the puck past Bennington to extend the lead to 2-0 with 19:30 left in regulation. Video, STL8 Florida. Barkov stuffs home Hoffman's feed for PPGBY, registering a point against the Blues. Barkov became the second Panther to reach the 50-point mark this season, joining linemate Jonathan Huberto, who he now shares the team scoring lead with. Of Barkov's 19 goals this season, 8 have come with the extra attacker. Entering the night leading all NHL forwards in average ice time, Barkov skated 22-14 against St. Louis, while also winning 14 of 22 draws in the faceoff circle, the 12th time in his last 13 games that he's finished with a winning percentage of 50% or better in the dot. Point 4. Playing with power. When the Panthers head to the power play, opposing teams are put on notice. Entering the game with the 4th-ranked power play in the NHL, Florida pocked 2 more goals with the extra attacker on Tuesday night, giving them at least 1 goal with the man advantage in 31 of the last 42 games. In that span, they have converted on 42 of their 138 opportunities since November. 1. The Panthers' power play success rate of 30.4% ranks first in the NHL, with a secondary assist on Barkov's goal. Keith Yandel also notched his team-leading 26th power play point of the season, which places him tied for fourth in the NHL and first among all defensemen. The 32-year-old also leads Florida's Blue Liners in points, 40, and assists, 33.5. Momentum shift. When asked about what went wrong during Tuesday night's game, Boughner said he felt the momentum start to shift about midway through the second period. After winning the possession battle in the first period, Florida was out-attempted by St. Louis 40-22 at 5-on-5 over the final 40 minutes of play. Of those 40 attempts, 18 were considered scoring chances and 8 came from high-danger areas, with 2 of those attempts turning into goals. They made their push again, Barkov said of the Surge Street. Louis made in the game's second half. They're a good team, especially their first line. We couldn't handle them in our own zone. They got a lot of chances to score and finally found the way in the net 3 times. We had our chances, too. We should have just kept playing the way we played in the first period.